So Maros the Law, Doomsday Machine, in a partnership with Jan Fevaki's YouTube channel and Metal to Infinity web scene, has the honor to interview Wolfheart this afternoon. So thanks, Laurie, for being here. And my first question is, Wolfheart has definitely a specific way of doing metal, and we can see that from far. But why did you choose winter metal to describe yourselves?
I think it's because of the mostly for the first album Tuomas did by himself. It's named Winterborn, and the theme around the album is, you know, strongly related around winter. And also, I think, you know, winter is one of the coolest seasons. It has it's harsh, it's cold, but at the same time it's very beautiful. Beautiful, and overall, you know, I don't know, maybe let's say some certain interest into nature in general. You know, it's like the force of nature is something, you know, overwhelming, and you know, you can relate that to like many things. Also the winter, the coldness and the beauty and the harshness and yeah.
Okay. So since the beginning, Wolfheart has been surprising people around the globe, bringing great albums to the audience. Four full-length albums is very productive for only 6 years of existing. How do you explain this creativity, and how do you deal with such success, and is there much pressure for the upcoming albums?
Well, I don't know if there's much pressure for the upcoming albums. I think, you know, Tuomas is the main composer, obviously. He writes like 99% of the material, and I don't think, you know, taking like any specific pressures about the albums, and he's always been very creative and productive when it comes to writing songs and making music. So we already have some stuff ready for the next album, and we already scheduled when we are going to the studio and about the release and all that kind of stuff. So I don't know where the creativity comes or something like that, but it just comes and yeah, suits for us well.
And can you explain the band's name, who chose it, why and how was it chosen? People are probably guessing it's due to Moonspell album.
No, it has nothing to do with the Moonspell album, but I guess the name more like chose itself. It was like the working title or project title when Tuomas was kind of building up the band or making the music by himself. And after all, you know, it seemed to like fit the music and fit like the whole theme nicely, the wolf heart, you know, as a wolf as an animal, and like a, let's say like a, I don't know, maybe as a, like a mental state or something like that, you know. So yeah, but nothing, I guess nothing to do with Moonspell album, but more likely that it's maybe chose itself, I think.
Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so this European tour has been long, and how has been the feedback of the audience so far, and what can we expect for tonight's show?
Yeah, it has been long. We've been, Wolfheart has been touring a lot. This is the fifth tour and the longest on the Constellation of the Black album, latest album. And feedback from the audience has been really good. Highlights have definitely been at least Hellfest and Full Force festivals, which were really nice. And tonight I think you can expect an aggressive and fast-paced, yeah.
And then suppose you are in a desert island and you don't have internet, no radio, you have only a record player with batteries, and you are only allowed to listen to three albums. Which albums would you choose to listen to?
Ah, difficult one. All right. I see. Well, obviously I would choose some album, you know, that I've been involved with creating somehow. Maybe, let's say, some Wolfheart album or Blood of the Hourglass album or... then I would choose something mellow and easygoing, you know, relaxing music. I don't know, maybe it could be Californication from Red Hot Chili Peppers. It was one of the first albums I purchased. And let's say Constellation from Wolfheart. And lastly, I don't know, I have to think about it a little. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'm going to go with Godsend from Blood Red Hourglass, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Thanks.
So, and to finish our interview, so would you like to leave a message to your fans around the world?
Yeah. Go to shows and show your support.
So thanks for being here. Thanks for the interview, and stay heavy.
Stay heavy. Thank you.